Hi friends, my name is Chaitanya Bhatke and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to analyze the Super 4 game between Afghanistan and Sri Lanka, which took place at the Sharjah Cricket Stadium. Sri Lanka won the toss and chose to bowl first. They restricted Afghanistan to 175 for 6, which was, I think, Afghanistan were 10 to 15 runs short by the start they got due to Rehmanullah Gurbaz. But we will come to that in a minute. Hazratullah Zada scored 13 runs of 16 deliveries. He was all at sea in this innings, unfortunately. As we know that the ball keeps a little bit low on the Sharjah wicket, and it was a used wicket. So, we predictably know that Zada doesn't move his feet very much. So, he's predominantly a hand-eye coordination player. And when the bounce is good, he takes the ball towards mid-wicket region and smashes it there. But due to the lack of bounce, he was undone. And he was bowled by Dilshan Madushanka of 13. Rehmanullah Gurbaz played one of the best innings in T20s, and I'm not exaggerating it. 84 of 45 deliveries, which included 4 boundaries and 6 massive sixes, was equally at home against the spinners as well as the fast bowlers. He particularly chose to attack Mahesh Dikshana at the start of the power play, which is Sri Lanka's trump cards. And at one moment, it seemed that he was caught at long off. But unfortunately for Sri Lanka, that the fielder's foot touched the rope and it was adjusted as a 6. The very next delivery of the next over, Rehmanullah Gurbaz smashed Dilshan Madushanka for a huge 6 over fine leg, which made clear his intentions. If the ball was shot outside the off stump, he took a full liking and made the Sri Lankan bowlers pay for it. And he ran between the wickets terrifically as well, kept the scoreboard moving. And he was particularly good against the fast bowler as well, targeting them on the leg side towards mid wicket and cow corner area as well, playing fearlessly and selfishly, non-selfishly, I beg your pardon, because he had a brilliant chance to complete his 100, but he wanted Afghanistan to reach a maximum score as possible. So in the midst of hitting against the run of play, he got out, but one of the most magnificent innings. And as we know that he was with Gujarat Titans this year, and he didn't get a game, unfortunately, because the Gujarat lineups foreigners spots were stacked with superstars like Rashid Khan and David Miller. But certainly he's making a strong case of making his IPL debut in next year as well. So all the best to Rehmanullah Gurbaz, and Afghanistan has to look after him very well, because Afghanistan have found a future superstar. Ibrahim Zadran scored 17 of 10 deliveries, unfortunately couldn't kick on. Najibullah Zadran also was out for an identical score. Rashid Khan scored 9 of 7 deliveries, including 1-6 in the last over, which propelled Afghanistan to above 170. And Mohammad Nabi couldn't fire with the bat in this game. Coming to Sri Lanka's bowling analysis, Mahesh Dikshana bowled wonderfully well, despite the fact that Rehmanullah Gurbaz took a liking to him in the power play and smashed him for a couple of shots. In 4 overs, he gave away 29 runs and took a solitary wicket. Ashita Fernando, in 4 overs, he gave away 34 runs and took a wicket. Dilshan Madushanka was instrumental in picking up the wicket of Hazratullah Zazai, but he went for more than 9 runs per over. 4 overs, 37 runs, 2 wickets. Vanindu Hasaranga went wicketless this match, but he bowled pretty well. His lines were pretty tight, and it resulted in figures of 23 runs in just 4 overs, well below the 6 run per over mark, so which is taken by the captain any given day of the week. Chamika Karunaratne was expensive, 20 runs in 2 overs. And Dashun Shanaka took 2 wickets for 22 runs, mixed his cutters and slower ones well. I don't know why he didn't bowl his quota of 4 overs, but anyways, he managed to restrict Afghanistan to 175, which was a decent score on that pitch. But Afghanistan were feel that they were short by a few runs. Coming to Sri Lanka's innings, Sri Lanka chased down this target 179 for 6 with 5 deliveries to spare in the last over. Pathum Nisanka scoring 35 of 28. He looked good, but unfortunately got out against the run of play. His innings included 3 boundaries and a 6. Kushal Mendis was also in great form, as was evident from his innings against Bangladesh. He carried that confidence from that innings into this one. 2 boundaries, 3 sixes, 36 of 19, and he would have loved to carry on, but he also got out. But that gave the Sri Lankan openers a brilliant start, both of them. Charit Asalanka's horror run of form continues. As we know that he made a name for himself in the last T20 World Cup, but couldn't muster much runs in this innings as well. Third consecutive failure for him, 8 of 14 deliveries. He was out by Mohammad Nabi. Danushka Gunathilka looked extremely well. he had a bit of aji baji with Rashid Khan as well. Later, both of them tried to mix up, but there was a simmering tension between the two, and it made for good optics. 33 of 20 deliveries, 2 fours, 2 sixes, and he was bowled by Rashid Khan. So, Rashid had the last laugh. Dasun Shanaka, the skipper, went from 10 of 9 deliveries. Mujibur Jhadran took his wicket. Bhanuka Rajapakses playing a blinder towards the end, 31 of 14 deliveries, which included a solitary 6 and 4 boundaries, took the game away from Afghanistan, where it was looking that the Afghan spinners are choking the Sri Lankan middle order. That's what the X factor does, as we Bhanuka Rajapaksha has demonstrated towards the early part of IPL 2022 with Punjab Kings, and he is a rare talent, and Sri Lanka has lucky to have him, and he must be back in spite of a few failures, but this sort of innings more than makes up for the previous incidences of failure. So great by Bhanuka Rajapaksha, targeted the mid-wicket boundary and ran between the wickets as well. But running between the wickets shouldn't be a strong forte, because it doesn't need to for Bhanuka, because he played so well. He played, employed the sweep shot to greater effect, and his play towards the leg side is world class. So a brilliant innings for him. He was bowled by Naveen ul Haq, but it was too little too late for Afghanistan. Vanindu Hasaranga also played a cameo, 16 of 9 deliveries, which includes 3 boundary, and it just wiped off the additional pressure and tension in the Sri Lankan dressing room. And Chamika Karunaratne finished off with a boundary, 5 runs of 2 deliveries. Fazal Haq Farooqi disappointed in this match as well. He didn't had a last game as well. So despite the fact that he didn't let Sri Lankan batsman score in the opening Super 6 game, his last two games have been a disappointed. 3.1 overs, 34 runs, no wickets. Mujibur Rahman bowled excellently well, 4 overs, 30 runs, 2 wickets. Mixed his variations well, employed the googly to good effect, employed the carom ball as well, which dumbfounded Sri Lankan batsman on certain occasion. And the carom ball took a wicket of a batsman as well. Naveen ul Haq, 4 overs, 40 runs, 2 wickets. We have seen that against other opposition as well. Naveen ul Haq, once he starts leaking runs, there is no stopping it. So he has to work on that aspect, because it is detrimental for Afghanistan counts. And despite the fact that he took 2 wickets, going for 10 runs per over never helps. Rashid Khan in 4 overs, he gave away 39 runs and took a single wicket. He was very expensive by his own standards. And it is an off game, I would say, for Rashid. And I hope he bounces back in the next game. I hope he doesn't as well, because Afghanistan's next game against India is against Pakistan. So he does, but yes, Rashid would be disappointed, because he has great control, immaculate light and length, and it is expected that he gives between 20-24 runs per over, but 39 is too much for a bowler of his standard. And Mohammad Nabi was also expensive in 4 overs, he gave away 34 runs by taking a solitary wicket. So all in all, a great victory for Sri Lanka, and that would do their confidence a world of good, and that also stands them in good stead against India. So we will do a preview of that game as well. But Afghanistan fought very nicely. They were shot by a few runs, which ultimately costed them this game. So how did you like my analysis? Please tell in the comment section below, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and press the bell icon for further notifications. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, everyone, bye.